I got a lot of love for these geometric grannies on Granny Square month call last year, so I decided to make a new one. I'm going to put these together and make Granny Square that resembles something like this. So in the beginning we need to make these 1/8 of a granny square shapes too and join them together. So you can pick smallest leftovers for the beginning because these rows are like really, really, really small. First DC, chain, and two DCs. First row. For a second part, magic circle. I did something weird there. For the first one. 1, 2, 3. It's our first DC. Two DCs together. 1 DC and a chain space. So, because we need different sides. Now, second row. We could attach yarn. 1, 2, 3 as DC. 1 for the chain space. Then 3 DCs. Chain 1. Last DC in the chain. I think it's third chain. Yes, 1, 2, 3. Third chain. It's like top on top of DC. First row's DC. So. We have second row. So you can always start with standing DC. I'm gonna show it for this piece. Standing DC. Chain 1, 3 DCs. DC and the last DC of previous row. So. Now on to the third row. And again, you can start with adding new yarn and making three chains, fourth DC, then fourth chain, and you can start with standing DC. So your choice actually. So now we are here and we need to do full granny bit and half of it. Full first. Chain and half. Half is two because one is as if that one and the other one is for the edge. Should take this one somewhere else. So we did this bit. Now, and here we're going to do this one, half and full. It was full and half for this part, and now it's half and full for the other part. So I think I prefer, it might actually be confusing making both sides at the same time. So, standing DC done, chain one, and it's the half, no, without the chain, standing DC, DC. Because this is the half side and this is the corner side. DC. So, let's see. So, next row. Yarn, and three and fourth, DC, and the second one full. And for this side, we're finished here, so I'm attaching my new yarn here. Oh, DC. I'm actually not a fan of standing DC, so I'm not sure why I'm making it here, but somehow I am. So we start with two full DCs. No, not full DCs, but full DCs. granny. Definitely not. Kids at him. Crazy. I wonder if you can hear them playing in the first floor. I'm actually hiding. Pretty much just repeat. You have to remember that here is 1DC or 2DCs and every other row, and you can make it as big as you want. They are pretty much the same. And if you're wondering, for this project, I'm using milk yarn because of late night shopping in AliExpress. So, let's make next row. And now, while making the last row, we're gonna join it to the other side. So let's start and pull yarn through and chain and pull yarn through. This is PLT join, and I thought it's the best join for this part. The beginning is weird, but after we weaving ends, it won't be seen, so it's all good. Voila, we have made first part. Yay. Now we'll be adding the straight lines. As I wasn't pleased with the fact that this was single crochet border, I'm gonna skip this row and start with 8 DCs, not 9. And I've counted that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 spaces to do it, so it's perfect, as if meant to be. So attach your yarn in one of the corners. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 for the side. And let's make the DC 3 DCs. So let's test it. Would work. Two and 3. White on white looks really good. and here. And nope. Пока солит. Пиши, погоди еще. Все равно. So either you do it, chain one and last DC in the first beginning, or you do it like four chains and slip stitch in the beginning of that one. So your choice. Pretty good. And now we simply make shorter and shorter rows. Start the same and end the same. I'm gonna be switching sides so it looks the same from both sides. So one, two, three, four. And these three DCs. apart from creepy amount of yarn ends. This one is beautiful. I'm thinking DC border, but how smart are here? You need an actual let's unwind this a bit. And make something for the board. And 1, 2, 3. And single crochet. Why single crochet? I don't know. Probably slip stitch works just as well. Let's look at what I did for this. I made 1, 2 in the sides and 1 in the join spaces, like here. And then this is the corner. 2 and 1 in join space. Okay then. 1, 2 in the beginning, and a little bunch here. Oh, it's corner, it's like in the corner. So, well, let's try it out. Chain space, 1 in this join space. Join chain space formed by should be magic circle. So do in magic circle, chain 2, and again 2 in magic circle. These are bigger chain spaces, so I'm gonna use just 1 DC for the corner and 3 DCs in the chain spaces. basically, it will look as if it's if you haven't started watching yet, make 3 chains, not 4. Too much. 4 is too much. Corner, I'm thinking 2, chain 2, and 2. Let's finish it off. Each edge contains 29 stitches. As for normal good old granny square, but this one is like solid granny square ending and without the chain spaces, but it looks better for these kind of part squares in the middle. This looks too long. This chain space looks longer than DC, so I'm guessing it would be better to make 3 chains, or maybe start with standing DCs, as this is much smaller than this chain space. Approaches, not yet though. Soon, soon, soon. So. 1, 2, 3. And it's the same corner as this one. Just 1 now. 2 chains. 2 DCs, 2 DCs, 2 DCs, and we're again on this side, so it's 2 DCs and 1 in the joining space, and 2 DCs. So and slip stitch. I do two slip stitches usually, but I'm not going to keep this one, so like this. Late night shopping for black yarn. I think it looks great. So, same part and ending with stripes as for this one. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, like, comment, and see you soon. Bye-bye.